Hi my dears, Assalamu alaikum. How are you dears? All are fine? Okay. Today we are going to discuss our new chapter, The Sermon at Benares.
What is that?
The Sermon at Benares. It's a life history of our Gautama Buddha. I think you all of you familiar with the Gautama Buddha. Okay, the Sermon at Benares is a chapter written by Betty Renshaw. Okay, who is that? Betty Renshaw. Betty Renshaw. Story of our Gautama Buddha. The Sermon at Benares is a chapter written by Betty Renshaw. I told you that. Betty Renshaw. Then here, the chapter covers the journey of Gautama Buddha from princehood to a saintly life. Okay, after seeing the sufferings of the world, he decided to give up all worldly pleasures and sought enlightenment, and he finally attained salvation under a tree, Bodh Gaya. Then I think already studied in your SS classes that about Gautama Buddha and his life. Right here, at the age of 25, he gave up all his worldly pleasures and lead a peaceful, calm, saintly life. Okay, then all of you listen. Then what is the meaning of sermon? It's a moral talk. Okay, it's a moral talk. That we can call sermon. Then here we are going to discuss our new chapter, The Sermon at Benares. Moral talk. Moral talk. Okay, all of you. Then open your textbook. And look at your textbook. Gautama Buddha began life as a prince named Siddhartha Gautama in northern India. At 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures. And 4 years later, he returned home to marry a princess. Okay. And they had a son and lived for 10 years as befitted royalty. At about the age of 25, the prince, heretofore shielded from the suffering of the world. Okay, and while cut hunting chanced upon a sick man, then an aged man, then a funeral procession, and finally a monk begging for alms. Okay. These sights so moved him that he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment concerning the sorrows he had witnessed. He wandered for 7 years and finally sat down under a peepal tree where he vowed to stay until enlightenment came. Enlightened after 7 days, and he renamed the tree the Bodhi tree, the tree of wisdom, and began to teach and to share his new understandings. At that point, he became known as the Buddha, and what is meaning the awakened or enlightened. The Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Benares, most holy of the dipping place on the river Ganges, and the sermon has been preserved and is given here. It reflects the Buddha's wisdom about one inscrutable kind of suffering. Then all of you listen again. Which are the things happened in this chapter? Listen, my dears. Gautama Buddha then was a prince, right? Okay. Then his parents had named him, what his name? Siddhartha Gautama. and he had been shielded the sufferings of the world. What is meaning shielded? Anything to protect, be adjusted, the sufferings of the world. While out hunting, whatever at hunting time, the age of 25, he saw a sick man, an aged man, then a funeral procession. Okay, then he saw these things and also saw ascetic begging for alms. Okay, begging for alms. Okay, all of you listen. Then unable to understand that, he went in search of spiritual knowledge. Okay, while hunting, he saw four problems. What is that? All of you listen. A sick man, an aged man, and a funeral procession. A dead man. Okay, funeral procession. Then and finally, a monk. Begging for alms. For alms, begging for alms means something given to the poor. He's begging for alms. Sometimes it may be food or anything like that. Okay, then he was begging. A monk is begging for alms. Okay, then here, all of you listen. So he moved that, and he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment concerning the sorrows he had witnessed. Then he want to enlighten. He want answer concerning the sorrows he had witnessed. Which are the things he witnessed? He saw so many four things. He want to seek enlightenment. Enlightenment is state of high spiritual knowledge for answering these all things. Okay, and concerning the sorrows he had witnessed. He wandered for 7 years and finally sat down under a peepal tree. And where he vowed, then he vowed there a lot of time to stay until enlightenment came. Okay, at last enlightenment came. That means he got spiritual knowledge. And enlightened after 7 days, he renamed the tree the Bodhi tree, the tree of wisdom, and began to teach and to share his new understandings. And at that point, he became known as the Buddha. And the Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Benares. Okay, moral talk at the city of Benares. Most holy of the dipping place on the river Ganges. And that sermon has been preserved, is given here. It reflects the Buddha's wisdom about one inscrutable in something which cannot be understood and a kind of suffering. Then he saw four things. Then he couldn't get answer. Then he understood that it is better to leave everything, and he want to enlighten. That's why he went to that under a peepal tree. Then finally sat under a peepal tree, then he all of you witnessed, and he wandered for 7 years for getting answer of these questions, that these that with these four happenings. Okay, he want answer. That's why he wandered. He wandered means he go either and thither. Wander without, that means he want answer. That's why he wandered. Work a lot for getting answer of these all problems. Okay, then what he did, then under a peepal, then at last he finally sat under a peepal tree. Okay, then he vowed there and until enlightenment came. Enlightened after 7 days, what he did, he named that tree as Bodhi tree. That means tree of wisdom. Okay, he got wisdom from there, under that tree. That's why he called that tree as tree of wisdom, and began to teach and share his new understanding from that tree. Okay, from that tree. Then here began to teach and share his new understandings at the point of becoming known as Buddha. And here the Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Benares. Most holy of the dipping places on the river Ganges. And the sermon has been preserved and is given here. Then here, moral talk is given here, his first talk sermon at Benares. And it reflects the Buddha's wisdom about one, something which cannot be understood kind of suffering. Okay, here we have the answer. Buddha's opinion about the suffering. Okay. Kisa Gautami has an only son. And she died. In her grief, she carried the dead child to all her neighbors, asking them for medicine. And the people said, she has lost her senses. The boy is dead. At length, Kisa Gautami met a man who replied to her request, I cannot give the medicine for your child. I cannot give you. He means you. I cannot give you medicine for your child. But I know a physician who can. Then the girl said, pray, tell me, who is it? And the man replied, go to Sakyamuni, the Buddha. Okay. Do you know what we are going to? We are discussing now Kisa Gautami. Her son died, but she wants her son back. That's why she went to so many persons. And the girl said, pray, tell me, sir, who is it? And the man replied, go to Sakyamuni, the Buddha. Kisa Gautami replied to the Buddha and cried, Lord and Master, give me the medicine that will cure my boy. The Buddha answered, I want a handful of mustard seed. And then the girl in her joy promised to procure, that means obtain it. The Buddha added, the mustard seed must be taken from a house where no one has lost a child, husband, parent or friend. Okay, I want a handful of mustard. But what is the speciality of mustard? You can buy from anyone. But what condition? What is that? Here, from a house where no one has lost a child, husband, parent or friend. Okay, I want mustard from one home that no one died from there. All of them went to there. Okay, no one died from there. Poor Kisa Gautami now went from house to house and the people pitied her and said, here is mustard seed. Take it. But when she asked, did a son or daughter, a father or mother die in your family? They answered, alas. They answered her, alas, the living are few, but the dead are many. Understood? Living are few, but dead are many. Don't remind us for our deepest grief. Understand what they said? Don't remind about that grief. Okay. Then, and there was no house, but some beloved one had died in it. No, but in all houses, anyone may die. Okay. Then, Kisa Gautami became very, very means tired, then hopeless, and sat down at the wayside, watching the lights of the city. Okay, what she said, what she did? She just sit down wayside watching the lights of the city as they flickered. Flickered means unsteadily flash or light a short moment, flickering. Okay, then she saw the unsteadily flash and it's just like a flickering. Okay, flickered up toward the extinguished again and down again. And at last, the darkness of the night reigned everywhere, the no lights or darkness. Then, and she considered the fate of men, and their leaves flicker up and extinguished again. Okay, then what she understood the fate of man. It will flicker up, that means it will light and unsteadily flash or illegally short moment. Is extinguished, its end. Okay, destroy or put out and read every word. And she considered the fate of men and their leaves flickered up and are extinguished again. Like, so now we just think about our lives, our leaves and everything. Okay, yeah, we are flickering now, and surely we can expect our death at any time. Right. Okay, and it's extinguished. Surely we also extinguished. Right. Yes. And she thought to herself, how selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. Underline, how selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. Yet in this valley of dissolution, there is a path that leads him to immortality who has surrendered all selfishness. What she said, all of you listen. How selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. And yet, in this valley of dissolution, an area which is filled with deep sorrow, there is a path that leads him to immortality and who has surrendered all selfishness. Okay, who has surrendered their selfishness, surely we have a path of immortality. Understood, all of you? We are immortal in the minds of others. Just think about everything. Okay, number selfishness ne and the end surrender cheyanengil le, who has surrendered, we have there is a path, or underline, I told you that there is a path that leads him to immortality who has surrendered all selfishness. The Buddha said, the life of mortal in this world is troubled and brief and combined with pain. Okay, Buddha, then what Buddha said that, yes, surely the life of mortals, just think about ourselves, and in the world it's troubled and brief and combined with pain. Okay, further, there is not any means by which those that have been born can avoid dying. Okay, we have no means, no way for avoiding our dying. And after reaching old age, there is death. Of such a nature are living beings. Okay, then as ripes up, all of you listen, as ripe fruits are early in danger of falling. Okay, even in the case of ripe fruits are early in danger of falling. So mortals when born are always in danger of death. In mortal, we the people also danger, in the danger of death. Understood? Just like fruits and everything in the world, death is common to all. Everything in the world are expecting their death at any time. Okay, and as all certain earthen vessels made by the potter end in being broken. Understood? Even it is in the case of earthen vessels, made by soil, and its potter and end by broken. And so is the life of mortals, both young and adults, both those who are fools and those who are wise. It's common to all. If it is a wise person, is there any chance for live long? No chance. No way. All are waiting for their death. And all fall into the power of death. All are subject to death. Okay. All are subject to death. Then, if you are a wise person, no, surely we can expect our, if it is neither you are a fool, neither you are a wise person, we are expecting our death always. Of those who overcome by death, depart from life, a father cannot save his son, nor kinsmen their relations. Mark, while relatives are looking on and lamenting deeply, one by one mortals are carried off like an ox that is led to the slaughter. Then, so the world is afflicted with the death and decay. Therefore, the wise don't grieve and knowing the terms of the world. Okay, another important point is that of those who overcome by death, who can overcome by death, depart from life, a father cannot save his son, nor kinsman, like kinsman's relationship, like relation there, we no one save their relations. Mark, while the deities are looking on and lamenting deeply, and one by one mortals are carried off, and like an ox that is led to the slaughter, means killing flesh, surely they also waiting for their death. So the world is afflicted with death and decay. Okay, the world is afflicted with, means affected by suffering or the disease or the pain of death. And so the world is afflicted with death and decay. Therefore the wise don't grieve. Then what we want to do? The wise don't grieve, knowing the terms of the world. Even though if you are a wise person, surely we don't want to cry. Okay, not from weeping, not from grieving will anyone obtain peace of mind. Then again another advice, what is that? Okay, no wise person, that means no wise person, the wise don't grieve. Okay, wise aitla alkar orikkalum endana thangalde sangadathe parannittu orikkalum karayavilla. Understood? നമുക്ക് സംഭവിച്ചത് മോശകാലങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ച്, നമുക്ക് സംഭവിച്ചിട്ടുള്ള മോശകാലങ്ങൾ, നമുക്ക് സംഭവിച്ചിട്ടുള്ള എന്താണ് നെഗറ്റീവ്സിനെ കുറിച്ച് ബുദ്ധിയുള്ള ആൾക്കാർ പറഞ്ഞ് കരഞ്ഞിരിക്കൂല. പകരം എന്താണ്? ഷുവർലി വാട്ട് വിൽ ദേ ഡു? നോട്ട് ഫ്രം വീപ്പിംഗ്, നോട്ട് ഫ്രം ഗ്രീവിംഗ് വിൽ എനി വൺ ഒബ്ടെയിൻ പീസ് ഓഫ് മൈൻഡ്. ഒത്തിരി നേരം സങ്കടപ്പെട്ടിരുന്നിട്ടോ, കരഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടിരുന്നിട്ടോ എന്താണ്, എനി വൺ ഒബ്ടെയിൻ പീസ് ഓഫ് മൈൻഡ്, ആർക്കും മനസ്സിന് എന്ത് കിട്ടില്ല, സമാധാനം കിട്ടില്ല. ഓക്കെ, ഓൺ ദ കോൺട്രറി ജസ്റ്റ് അഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് ഹിസ് പെയിൻ വിൽ ബി ദ ഗ്രേറ്റർ ആൻഡ് ഹിസ് ബോഡി വിൽ സഫർ. ഓക്കെ, we didn't get our peace of mind, but against that, what will we get? We will be greater and his body will suffer. Okay, our pain will be greater. കരഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടിരുന്ന ഒരിക്കലും എന്താണ് നമ്മുടെ പെയിൻസ് കുറയില്ല, പകരം എന്താണ് നമ്മുടെ പെയിൻസ് അത് കൂട്ട്. Pain will be greater and his body will suffer. He will make himself sick and pain. That if I am crying like that, weeping over my sorrows, over my negatives, over any death of my dearest one or anything, surely it will make myself sick or pain. I am become pain. Okay. Then yet the dead are not saved by this lamentation. Okay, but no one, that in the case of lamentation means mourning, on mourning, m-o-a-n-i-n-g, mourning, that crying, not retrieve or net back that death peasant again. And yet the dead are not saved by this lamentation, this crying, express of sorrow. നമ്മളിങ്ങനെ ദുഃഖിച്ചിരുന്നുകൊണ്ട് കരഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടിരുന്നുകൊണ്ട് ഒരിക്കലും എന്താണ് മരിച്ചു പോയ ആള് തിരിച്ചു വരാൻ പോകുന്നില്ല. He who seeks peace should draw out the arrow of lamentation and complaint and grief. Okay, we want to avoid. If you want peace, surely you want to draw out, you want to keep out, you want to left all the arrow of lamentation and complaint and grief. Everything you want to quit. Okay, and grief. And he who has drawn out the arrow and has become composed, calm, become composed means become calm, will obtain peace of mind. ആരാണോ അങ്ങനെ ലാമെൻറ്റേഷൻസ് അല്ലെ, കരച്ചിലും സങ്കടം പറച്ചിലുകൾ, എന്താണ് ഒരാളുടെ പേരും പറഞ്ഞിങ്ങനെ എന്താണ് വെറുതെ ഇരുന്ന് കരയാൻ തുടങ്ങി, കരഞ്ഞ് എന്താണ് അതൊക്കെ അങ്ങനെയാണ് അവർ നിൽക്കുന്നതെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ എന്താണ് അതിൻ്റെ ഡ്രോബാക്ക്? എന്താ ഇറ്റ്സ് വിൽ പെയിൽ ദം, അത് അവർക്ക് തന്നെ നെഗറ്റീവായിട്ട് അവരുടെ ബോഡിക്ക്, അവരുടെ മനസ്സിന് തന്നെ നെഗറ്റീവായിട്ട് ബാധിക്കും, അത് അവരുടെ സിക്കാക്കി മാറ്റും. അല്ലാതെ ഇഫ് വി ഡു ദൻ He who has drawn out the arrow and has become composed, then nammada lamentations ok vachirne, and who become composed, become calm, will be obtain peace of mind. Adukku oluva akiyale endalo nammala da we become, what is that, all of you read. He who has drawn out, left the arrow means arrow of lamentation, and has become calm, will obtain peace of mind. ആരാണോ ഇതൊക്കെ ഒഴിവാക്കുന്നത്, എന്തൊക്കെ ഒഴിവാക്കുന്നത്, ആരാണോ തന്റെ സ്വന്തം സങ്കടങ്ങളെ വലിച്ചെറിയുന്നത്, അത് ഡ്രോൺ ഔട്ട്, ജസ്റ്റ് ലീവ് ലെഫ്റ്റ്, ഷുവർലി ദാറ്റ് പേഴ്സൺ വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് പീസ്. ഓക്കെ, ഹീ ഹു ഹാസ് ഓവർകം ഓൾ സോറോ will become free from sorrow. ആരൊക്കെയാണോ തന്റെ സങ്കടങ്ങളെ മറികടന്ന് ഫ്രീ ആവാൻ ശ്രമിക്കുന്നത് അല്ലേ? He who has overcome all sorrows will become free from sorrow and be blessed. Then only what will be that? Then we can call be blessed. Okay, then don't cling upon your sorrows. Surely here, Buddha gave important about that death process. That means lamenting over a death and all. But we can use these all things in our life also. How we can use? Because surely if we have any negative effects, if we have any negative habits, or if everything, if you can't control anything, surely leave everything. Okay, then leave all your grief, leave all your sorrows and everything, and leave peacefully. Understood? Understood all of you? നമുക്ക് സങ്കടങ്ങൾ അല്ലേ, നമ്മളുടെ സങ്കടങ്ങൾ, നമ്മളുടെ കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ നമ്മുടെ മനസ്സിലുണ്ടാവും. അതിനൊക്കെ എന്താണ്, just goodbye to them and leave strongly. Okay, forward. Understood? മുന്നോട്ട് നന്നായിട്ട് സ്ട്രോങ് ആയിട്ട് എന്ത് ചെയ്യാം, ജീവിച്ച് കാണിച്ചു കൊടുക്കാം. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? അല്ലാതെ സോറോസിൽ കരഞ്ഞിരിക്കുകയല്ല വേണ്ടത്. അത് നമ്മളുടെ കൂടുതൽ എന്താക്കും, നമ്മുടെ സോറോസിനെ കൂടുതലാക്കും. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? അതിനെയൊക്കെ ഒഴിവാക്കിയിട്ട് എന്താണ്, ബി സ്ട്രോങ് ആൻഡ് ബി കൺട്രോൾ അവർ സെൽസ് ആൻഡ് ദോസ് ഹൂ ഡൂയിങ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ് ഷുവർലി ദേ ബിക്കം ഫ്രീ ഫ്രം സോറോ ആൻഡ് ബി ബ്ലെസ്ഡ്. ഓക്കേ, ദിസ് ഈസ് അവർ ചാപ്റ്റർ. ഐ തിങ്ക് യു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റുഡ് റൈറ്റ്. മനസ്സിലായോ? കിസ ഗൗതമിയാണ് ഡെത്തിന്റെ കാര്യം കൊണ്ടുവരാം, ഡെത്തിന്റെ കാര്യം ഈ ചാപ്റ്ററിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവന്നത്. കിസ ഗൗതമി അല്ലേ? കിസ ഗൗതമിന്റെ മോൻ മരിച്ചു. പിന്നെന്തൊക്കെയാ, ഡയറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഷീ വോണ്ട് ഹിം ബാക്ക്. ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ ഷീ വാണ്ടഡ് ആൻഡ് ഷീ നോ അബൌട്ട് അവർ ബുദ്ധ ആൻഡ് ബുദ്ധ ഗീവ് വൺ അഡ്വൈസ് ആൻഡ് ബട്ട് ഷീ ഡിഡ് ഗെറ്റ് എനിത്തിങ് ഡിഡ് ഗെറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് മസ്റ്റാർഡ് സീഡ് ഫ്രം ഫ്രം ഹൗസ് ബിക്കോസ് ഇൻ ഓൾ ഹൗസ് ലൈ എവ്രി ഹൗസ് യു വി നോ ദാറ്റ് തിങ് അല്ലേ. അതായത് ഒരു മരണം പോലും നടക്കാത്ത ഒരു പോലും നമ്മളുടെ ലോകത്ത് തന്നെ ഉണ്ടാവില്ല. ജസ്റ്റ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. അപ്പൊ എന്താണ്, ഡെത്ത് ഈസ് കോമൺ ടു ഓൾ. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റുഡ്? ദെൻ ഫ്ലിക്കറിംഗ് ഓഫ് ലൈറ്റ്സ്, അത് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ആട്ടോ, ഫ്ലിക്കറിംഗ് ഓഫ് ലൈറ്റ്സ്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് എന്താണ്, ഒരിക്കലും ക്ലിങ് അപ്പോൾ അവർ സോറോസ്, നമ്മുടെ അതിന് തൂങ്ങിക്കിടക്കരുത്. സോറോസ് സങ്കടങ്ങൾ നീ പതിലൊന്നും എന്ത് ചെയ്യരുത്, നമ്മൾ തൂങ്ങിക്കിടക്കരുത്. അതിന് പകരം അതിനൊക്കെ ഓവർകം ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്, എന്നാൽ മാത്രമേ ഇതിനൊഴിവിക്കാൻ ലീവ് peacefully. Understood my dears? Okay, take it in a positive sense and do like that. Okay, then just leave all your grief, all your sorrows. It's our time of our study well. Okay my dears, then all of you want to read the chapter well, inshallah I will give you the question answer. Okay, thank you. Hi my dears, Assalamu alaikum. How are you dears? All are fine? Okay. Today we are going to discuss our new chapter, The Proposal. What's the name of our chapter? Yes, The Proposal. The Proposal by Anton Chekhov. Okay, it's a proposal by Anton Chekhov. Then I told you that it's a play. I think it's our last chapter in our English textbook. It's a play, The Proposal. Then, as the word itself, its meaning, what its meaning? We know that, to propose something. Okay, here all of you listen. Actually, it's a Russian play. Actually, it's a Russian play. It's a humorous drama of simple folk. Okay. Then here, who are warm-hearted and affectionate and friendly, but are too touchy and sensitive. Okay. It's a simple play of our. It's a simple play of Anton Chekhov. And have you know what is the speciality of Anton Chekhov? Yes, normally it's heart-touching stories. Heart-touching stories we get through our Anton Chekhov. Okay, then here it's a play. Play. Then have you know the difference between drama and play? What is the difference between drama and play? We know that drama mainly concerned, mainly intended, sometimes we can call it's a composition, only give more important in writing, and also it have a story, right? Okay, it's in a serious manner. But in the case of play, play means it's mainly amusement. Okay, we are using that play for amusement. It's short, and also exceptional cases also. And we can mainly where we can see play. We can see plays in between youngsters are the actors. Okay, youngsters are the characters in that our play. Okay, then here we have our last chapter, the proposal. I told you that it's a simple play. Then here we have characters. Who are the characters in this story, in this play? Here Lamo, Chukko, and their Chukko's daughter also. Then here, if you listen here, Chukko, a landowner, and also Nadalia Septinova, his daughter, 25 years old, and Ivan Vasilevich Lamo, a neighbor of Chukko, a large and hearty but very suspicious landowner. Okay, these are the characters in our play. Okay, before going to our play, we want to discuss more about a Russian wedding. Okay, we have to know something about Russian wedding. Okay, all of you listen. Do you know anything about a Russian marriage ceremony? Read this article about a Russian wedding. Listen. Preparations for a Russian wedding. A Russian wedding is very simple. The planning only includes arranging for rings, bride's dress, cards, and reception. Earlier, the bride's family paid for the reception, but nowadays, brides and groom's families usually share expenses. A Russian wedding lasts for 2 days. Some weddings last as long as a week, and the occasion becomes something to remember for years. The necessary part of the wedding ceremony is a wedding procession of several cars. The best friends of the groom, bride, meet before the wedding a few times, make posters, write speeches, and organize concerts. When the groom arrives to fetch the bride for the registration, he has to fight to get her. I think you follow me, right? Listen. Russians usually live in apartments in tall buildings, and the groom has to climb several stairs to reach his bride. But at each landing, he must answer the question to be allowed to go up. The bride's friends ask difficult questions, sometimes about the bride, sometimes just difficult riddles, and the groom must answer with the help of his friends. For example, he may be shown a few photos of baby girls, and he must say which one his bride is. If he guesses wrong, he must pay cash to move ahead. After the marriage registration, the newly married couple leaves the guests for a tour of city sites. After 2 or 3 hours the city tour, the couple arrive at the reception. The couple sits at the specially arranged table with their family, friends, and invited guests. The reception starts with a toast to the couple. A wedding toast is a custom where a close friend or relative of the groom or the bride says a few words to which the couple, and then everyone raises their glass of wine and drink it up at the same moment. The groom is then asked to kiss the bride. After a few toasts, people start eating and drinking and generally have fun. After some time, the bride gets stolen and she disappears. And when the groom starts looking for her, he is asked to pay a fee. Usually, it is his friends who steal the bride. Then there are the bride's friends, they steal the bride's shoe. The groom must pay money for the shoe too. And the guests enjoy watching these tussles and continue party. Okay, then I think you read, you understood the ceremonies, you understood about our Russian wedding, right? Then which are the things happening before the wedding and after, that means and in between that. Then all of you know that, surely we know that there is a great difference between great difference from us, right? We are looking, we are concerning, we are thinking, marriages are surely it is precious one and no need any other malpractices and everything and nothing, and there is nowadays we try to reduce all the expenses of our marriage, of our marriage ceremonies, right? Then when we comparing with our Kerala's wedding style, it's not a little, but it's more than enough, right? When we concerning with, when we comparing with our with our expenditure, right? Okay, then do you think Indian and Russian wedding have any customs in common? With the help of the partner, fill in the blanks in the below. Okay, inshallah we can try to when at the time of opening day, inshallah if we get time surely we can discuss in our classroom. Okay, then the proposal originally titled A Marriage Proposal is a one-act play, a farce, and by the Russian short story writer Domestic Anton Chekhov. It was written in 1888 to 1889. Then the play is about a tendency of wealthy families to seek ties with other wealthy families and to increase their estate by encouraging marriage that made good economic sense. Okay, then Ivan Lomov, a long time wealthy neighbor of Stephen Chubkov, also wealthy, and comes to seek the hand of Chubkov's 25-year-old daughter Nadalia. Then all three are quarrelsome people and they quarrel over petty issues. The proposal is in danger of being forgotten amidst all this quarreling. Okay, we just forget about the proposal amidst all this quarreling. But economic good sense ensure that the proposal is made after all, although the quarreling perhaps continue. Then wait and see. We will discuss about. We can read our play. Okay. Okay, all of you open. Then here page number 144. Then who are the characters in our play? Stephen, Stepanovich Chubkov, landowner. Okay, Natalia Stepanovna, then his daughter, 25 years old. Ivan Vasilievich Lomov, a neighbor of Chubkov, a large, hearty, but very suspicious landowner. Okay, then all of you listen. We can understand which are the things happening here. A drawing room in Chubkov's house. Lomov enters, wearing a dress jacket and white gloves. Chubkov rises to meet him. Okay, that is the settings. Understood? Okay, Chubkov. My dear fellow, whom do I see? Ivan Vasilievich. I'm extremely glad, squeeze his hand. Now, this is a surprise, my darling. Who are you? Okay, my dear fellow, whom do I see? Ivan Vasilievich. Oh, I'm extremely glad. I'm very happy to see you. Okay, he is greeting him. Lomov, thank you. And how may you be getting on? That means, what about you? Then how old are you? How are you? That is, okay, how do you do like that? Chubkov, we just get along somehow. My angel, thanks to your prayers and so on. Sit down, please do. Now, you know, you shouldn't forget all about your neighbors, my darling. My dear fellow, what are you so formal in your getup? Evening dress, gloves, and so on. Can you be going anywhere, my treasure? Then, I told you that what is the setting then, how it's going on. Here, Chubko. Chubko, Chubko's house. Who is the neighbor of Chubko? Yes, Ivan Vasilevich. Lamo is the neighbor. He came to work to this Chubko. Chubko's house. ഇവിടെ ലെമോ വരികയാണ്. ഓക്കെ, കാഷ്വൽ ഡ്രസ്സിൽ നന്നായിട്ട് നല്ല സെറ്റപ്പോട് കൂടിയാണ് ആര് വരുന്നത്? ലെമോവ്. ലെമോവ് എങ്ങോട്ട് വരുന്നത്? ചുബ്കോന്റെ വീട്ടിലേക്ക് വരുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, ദൻ വി ജസ്റ്റ് ഗെറ്റ് അലോങ് സം ഹൗ മൈ ഏഞ്ചൽ, താങ്ക് ടു യുവർ പ്രയേഴ്സ്. അപ്പോൾ ചുബ്കോ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ എന്താണ്, വി ജസ്റ്റ് ട്രൈ ടു ഫ്ലാറ്റ് ഓൺ ഹിം. ആദ്യം തന്നെ എന്താണ് പൊക്കി വെക്കാൻ നോക്കുകയാണ് ആര്, നമ്മുടെ ലെമോവ്. വി ജസ്റ്റ് ഗെറ്റ് അലോങ് സം ഹൗ മൈ ഏഞ്ചൽ, താങ്ക്സ് ടു യുവർ പ്രയേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് സോ ഓൺ. ദെൻ സിരാ, ഓക്കെ, ദൻ സിറ്റ് ഡൗൺ പ്ലീസ്. ജു, നൗ യു നോ യു ഷുഡ് ഫോർഗെറ്റ് ഓൾ അബൌട്ട് യുവർ നൈബേഴ്സ് മൈ ഡാർലിംഗ്. മൈ ഡിയർ ഫെലോ, വൈ ആർ യു സോ ഫോർമൽ ഇൻ യുവർ ഗെറ്റപ്പ്? My dear, evening dress, gloves, and so on. Can you be going anymore? Oh, then I think that adhi njangalekku maaram. No. Endha poi vadiyokke? Endha po nalla dress illokke aanallo? Vera edhilum povunnallo? Nammal choikkolla. Casual aayittu nammal oraala kaanda nammal choikkolla. Adhu pole ṭo. Then Lomo. No. I have come only to see you. Honored Stephen Stepanovich. Then Chukko. Then why are you in evening dress, my precious? As if you're paying a New Year's Eve visit. Is it a New Year or New Year's visit? That's why. You see, it's like this. Then I have come to you, Honored Stephen Stepanovich. ഈ റെസ്പെക്റ്റ് ഒന്നും പിന്നെ നമുക്ക് കിട്ടില്ല. പിന്നെ നമ്മൾ ഇതിൽ ഈ പ്ലേയിൽ കാണില്ല. ഫസ്റ്റിൽ ഒരു ഭയങ്കര അങ്ങോട്ടും ഇങ്ങോട്ടും ബഹുമാനത്തിലാണ് സംസാരിക്കുന്നത്. ടു ട്രബിൾ ടു വിത്ത് എയർ റിക്വസ്റ്റ്, നോട്ട് വൺസ് ഓർ ചോയ്സ്, ഐ ഹാവ് ഓൾറെഡി ഹാഡ് ദ പ്രിവിലേജ് ഓഫ് applying to you for help, and you have always to speak. Then I must ask your pardon. I'm getting excited. I shall drink some water, Honored Stephen Stepanovich. He wanted to try to reveal something, but he couldn't. And then he asked some water drinks. Chipko, aside. He is come to borrow money. I know that. Aside means atmagadan less than that, but endana. He has come to borrow money. Sean gave him money. What is it? My beauty. That means, what is it? Okay, then, what is it, my beauty? That means, what is it, beauty? Beauty means a call. Then, Lamo. You see, Honored Stepanovich, I beg pardon, Stephen Honorich. I mean, I'm awfully excited. As you will please notice, in short, you alone can help me. You can tension of your our love most, and he become nervous and thought I don't deserve it. Of course, I haven't any right to count on your assistance. I know I didn't mention anything about your assistance earlier, your work and everything. Then Chukko, don't go round and round it. Darling, spit it out and work. That means don't go round and round, underline and write. Come to the point. Okay, just give me. Don't beat about the bush. Just come to the point. Then Lamo, one moment. This is this very minute. In fact, the fact is I have come to ask the hand of your daughter. Okay, Natalia Stepanova in marriage. Because because I want to propose your daughter. Okay. Chubko, Joffrey, my jaw, my God, Ivan Vasilevich said again. I didn't hear it all. Again, he couldn't believe. Okay, then Lomo, I have the honor to ask. Then Chubko interrupted, my dear fellow, I'm so glad. And so on. Yes, indeed, and all the sort of thing, and embraces and kisses Lomo. I have been hoping for it for a long time. He's waiting for this proposal, and it's been my continual desire. Okay, then he revealing something. It's my continual desire sheds tear, and I have always loved you, my angel, as if you were my own son. Okay, and may God give you both His help and His love and so on, and so much hope. Then what am I behaving in this idiotic way for? Then I'm off my balance with joy. I'm very happy. Then here, absolutely off my balance. Oh, with all my soul, I will go and call Natasha and all that. Okay, then greatly moved and honored, Stephen Stefanovich, do you think, then hear what happened. He is, by hearing these words, who become happy? Then here, Chubko become happy and excited. Okay, then he couldn't express his love to him. And also, then he ecstasy. Then Lavo greatly moved. Honor Stephen Stefanovich, do you think I'm count on her consent? That means agreement to do something. Then what is she is willing to? Then I don't know. She is willing to she is willing or not? Okay. Then Chukko, why? Of course, my darling. And as if she won't consent, she in love. Why? As if she won't consent. Then what is that? She is in love. She is longing for your love. Okay. She is waiting for you. Okay. She is waiting for your love. And she is like a lovesick cat and so on. Shan't be long. Okay. Don't confused. Don't misunderstood. Surely I know that my daughter is longing for your love. My daughter is longing for your love. Then he exit for calling who? Natasha. Then Lomo, it's cold. I'm trembling all over, just as if I have got an examination before me. Just like that. Okay. I'm trembling. I'm shivering because I got an examination. Okay. Then the great thing is, I must have my mind made up. If I give myself time to think, to hesitate, to talk a lot, to look for an ideal or for real love, then I will never get married. Okay, that is the reason. Then it's cold. Natalia step now. Okay, important. He become nervous. Okay, Stepnova is an excellent. Why he selected Natalia? Because she underlined, she is excellent housekeeper and not bad looking, well educated, and what more I want? Okay, she is excellent housekeeper, not bad looking, well educated. Because of these three reasons, he selected Natalia his partner. Okay, then what more do I want? But I'm getting a noise in my ears from excitement, dreams, and it's impossible for me not to marry. Then in the first place, I am already 35. Then he become confused. Then is it possible to marry her? Because I have already 35, a critical age, and so to speak. In the second place, I ought to lead a quiet and regular life. And I suffer from palpitation. Palpitation means a noisily rapid or irregular heartbeat. Irregular heartbeat and palpitation. Then another thing that means easily, in that short term word I recover. Okay, then here, what is that? I ought to lead a quiet and, first one is I am 35 years old. The second one, I ought to lead a quiet and regular life. I suffer from palpitation. Palpitation, I told you that a noticeably and then a rapid or irregular heartbeat. Rapid or heartbeat. Okay, then here I'm excitable and always getting awfully upset, easily upset. And at this very moment, my lips are trembling because I told you that he became nervous, right? And then I tremble, just like before the exam. The examiner prepares you. Exam munile face in the putte pole ayal anda thodangi, he become trembling and he become tension, become tensed. And there is a twitch. That means a sudden quick moment in of feeling in my right eyebrow. That means he become appo endana tension kondu undavuna and then physically illa endana appearance il undana prathegathagalana. Okay, then here eyebrow. But the very worst of all is the way I sleep. I no sooner get into bed and begun to go off. What is the another thing? All of you listen here. I no sooner get into bed and begin to go off. Then when suddenly something in my left side gives a pull and I can feel it is my shoulder and head. I jump up like a lunatic. Then by saying these all things, so endana ini endana sthithi endha aagum ennalladha alichittu endha avana, he become very tense. Then what happened here? He also sleep sickness also he have. What he have? And the kind of patient ana is 35 years old ana, heart patient ana, and also suffering from sleep sickness. And he must marry to lead a quiet and regular life. And what ana? Because 35 ana, then heart patient. I told you heart patient ana. Then this is the next one, my dears. Yes, sleep sickness and the sleep sickness. Sleep sickness. Okay, sleep sickness. Anna. Then already he want and then now he want. He must be carried a lead a quite regular life. Then why he? Ini anda ayam anda na. Avan married so that or regular life to quite type or regular life lead ayam. Na. Okay. Then I sleep. I no sooner get into bed and to begin to go off. Okay, then begin to go off. Then what is that? Then he couldn't go to bed early and also wake up early too. And I can feel it is my shoulder and head. Then he become started to shivering. I jump up like a lunatic. I jump up like a lunatic means just like a mentally ill person. Like lunatic na naale, and then insane and mentally ill person son. And walk above bed and lie down again. But soon as I began to get off sleep under another pull, and this might happen 20 times. Then he become and then ini andana tension adichadicha adeyam andana ayala allathe neeyana. Okay, Natalia. Ah well, third, it's you. And Papa said, go. There is a merchant come for his goods. How do you do, Ivan Vasilevich? And well, third, it's you. Idu ningalayirunno. Endana? My Papa said that. What said? Go, there is a merchant come for his goods. Papa said like that. Then Lomo, how do you do, honored Natalia Stepnova? Then okay, how do you do? Okay, then honored Natalia Stepnova. Then here Natalia, you must excuse my apron and negligence, and where shall it be for Jai? Why haven't you been here for such a long time? Sit down. And won't you have some lunch? What which other thing she said? All of you listen. You must excuse me, my apron, my negligence. Negligence means the it's night gown. Why I am in my night? Sorry, for I am in my night gown. We are shelling peas for drying. We are shelling peas for drying. Sorry, not loose. Why I am in this loose dress? Because we are shelling peas. And with peas and the na. Dry चेया मंडे डर ना तो बंदा ने यानी गाँव में लग sorry okay then all of you why haven't you been here for such a long time why you are here now such a long time after a long time okay sit down the seat themselves won't you have some lunch Lomo no thank you then I have had some already okay then Natalia then smoke here are the matches the weather is splendid now then okay then but yesterday it was so wet that the workmen didn't do anything all day okay then they directly go to their business and how much have you stocked then here just think I felt greedy and I had a whole field cut and now I am not at all or pleased about it because I'm afraid my hair may rot okay she had been enough to get the entire field cut which is worrying that is worrying now and they talk about the hair stock na kurichu palanirukana I ought to have waited a bit but what is this why you are in the evening dress well I never are you going to ball like dance music or ball party okay then or what through I must say you look better tell me were you get up like this why are you got up like this Okay, first direct ആയിട്ട് അവർ എന്തിനെ കുറിച്ച് സംസാരിച്ചത് അവർ നതാലിയ ഐ ടോൾഡ് യു ദാറ്റ് 25 ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഷുവർലി എ വെൽ നൈസ് എക്സലന്റ് ഹൗസ് കീപ്പർ ആണ് ദെൻ ഫസ്റ്റ്ലി ഷീ ഹാഡ് ബീൻ എന്താണ് ഷീ ഹാഡ് ബീൻ ഇനഫ് ടു ഗെറ്റ് ദ എൻറ്റയർ ഫീൽഡ് കട്ട് വിച്ച് ഈസ് വെറിങ് ദെൻ ഷീ ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ലിസൺ ഹിയർ വാട്ട് ഷീ സെഡ് ദേ ടോക്കിംഗ് അബൌട്ട് ദെയർ ഹെയർ സ്റ്റോക്ക് ഹെയർ സ്റ്റോക്ക് ആണ് ഹെയർ സ്റ്റോക്കിനെ കുറിച്ചാണ് വന്ന പാടെ തന്നെ ആര് സംസാരിക്കുന്നത് അവരുടെ ബിസിനസിനെ കുറിച്ചാണ് ദെൻ ഹിയർ ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ദെൻ സ്മോൾ ഹിയർ ആർ ദ മാച്ചസ് ദ വെതർ ഈസ് സ്പ്ലെൻഡിഡ് നൗ ബട്ട് യെസ്റ്റർഡേ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് സോ വെറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് വർക്ക്മാൻ ഡിഡ്ന്റ് ഡു എനിത്തിങ് ഓൾ ഡേ ബിക്കോസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് വെറ്റ് ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ മൈ വർക്ക്മാൻ ഡിഡ്ന്റ് ഡു ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഹി കുഡ്ന്റ് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ഹിസ് വർക്ക് ഓക്കെ Then, how much have you stopped? Just think, I felt greedy and had a whole field cut. Then I felt greedy and had a whole field cut. And now I am not all, not at all pleased about it because I am afraid my hair may not, hair may rot because it's wet already. Sure. Okay. Then here, love, excited. You see, honored Nathalia's are. Then she asked about his dress. Why are you worried? Then, Ramon, excited. You see, honored Nathalia Simnova, the fact is I have made up my mind to ask you to hear me out of course. Out of course, you will be surprised and perhaps even angry. But it's hopefully good. Okay. Then Nathalia, what's the matter? Course. Well. Then Ramon, I shall try to be brief. You must know, honored Nathalia Stepanova, then I have long since my childhood, in fact, had a privilege of knowing your family. All from our childhood onwards, I know you well. Then my late aunt and her husband, from whom, as you know, I inherited my land. You know that I inherited land from where? My aunt. Aunt and her husband always had a greatest respect for your father and your late mother. You know that. അപ്പോൾ വീണ്ടും എന്താണ് ബീറ്റിംഗ് അപ്പ് എന്ന് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഡയറക്റ്റ് ആയിട്ട് പ്രപ്പോസലിൻ്റെ കാര്യം പറയാതെ വീണ്ടും എന്താണ് അയാൾ വേറെ കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ഒരു ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ കൊടുക്കുകയാണ് മൈ ലേറ്റ് ഓൺ ഹർ ആൻഡ് ഹസ്ബൻഡ് ഫ്രം ഹൂം ആസ് യു നോ ഐ ഇൻഹെറിറ്റഡ് മൈ ലാൻഡ് ഓൾവേസ് ഹാഡ് ദ ഗ്രേറ്റസ്റ്റ് റെസ്പെക്ട് ഫോർ യുവർ ഫാദർ ആൻഡ് യുവർ മദർ ഓക്കെ ലേറ്റ് മദർ ഓക്കെ ദ ലമോ ആൻഡ് ദ ചുക്കോസ് ഹവ് ഓൾവേസ് ഹാഡ് എ മോസ്റ്റ് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ലമോ ചുക്കോൾസോ ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ആൻഡ് ഐ മൈറ്റ് ഓൾവേസ് സേ Almost say the most affectionate regard for each other and as you know my land is near neither of yours ente stalam ningalde aduthaneyana and you will remember my oxen meadows touch your birchwood ningalde birch tree tottu nikkuna oxen meadows ne kurichu ningalku ariyamallo then first enda pole parayan povunna vachale endana ayalu just or introduction kodunna oro karyangalum ingane വളച്ചൊച്ച് ഇപ്പൊ അവിടെ എത്തി ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് ഇപ്പൊ ബിർച്ചുവൂഡിന്റെ അടുത്താണ് പിന്നെ ഓണ്ടിനെ പിന്നെ ഞാനും നിങ്ങളൊക്കെ നല്ല നല്ല ഒരു റിലേഷൻ ആണ് കീപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്നതൊക്കെ നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാലോ ദെൻ നജാലിയ എക്സ്ക്യൂസ് മൈ ഇൻട്രോഡക്റ്റിംഗ് യു യു സേ മൈ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് ബട്ട് ആർ ദേ യുവേഴ്സ് ദെൻ ഹീ സെഡ് ദാറ്റ് വാട്ട് ഹീ സെഡ് ദാറ്റ് എന്റെ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് മീൻസ് ഗ്രാസ് ഫോർ അല്ലേ ഇതെന്താണ് ഗ്രേസ് ഓക്സൺ മെഡോ ഓക്സ് and meadows എന്നാണ് ഓക്സിനെ ഗ്രേസ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള ആ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് ഇല്ലേ എന്റെ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് നിങ്ങളുടെ ബിർച്ച് വുഡ്സിന്റെ അടുത്തുള്ള അവിടെ വരെ എത്തിയിട്ടുള്ളൂ ആര് നമ്മുടെ ലവോ നതാലിയ എക്സ്ക്യൂസ് മൈ ഇന്ററപ്റ്റിംഗ് യു യു സേ മൈ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോ ബട്ട് ആർ ദ യുവേഴ്സ് അത് നിങ്ങളുടെ ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് ആണ് ഓക്കെ ദേ സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ക്വാറലിംഗ് ഓക്കെ ദെൻ ലവോ യെസ് മൈ നതാലിയ What are you talking about? Oxen meadows are ours, not yours. Okay, then Lamo. No, my honored Nathalia Stepanovna. Then here Nathalia. Well, I never knew that before. How do you make that out? Lamo. How? I'm speaking of those oxen meadows which are wedged in between your birch woods and the burn marsh. Okay. ദെൻ നജാലിയ എന്താണ് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ യുവർ ബേർച്ച് വുഡിൻ്റെയും ബേർഡ് മാഷിൻ്റെയും എന്താണ് നടുവിലുള്ള ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസിനെ കുറിച്ചാണ് ഞാൻ പറയുന്നത് നജാലിയ യെസ് എസ് ദർ ഔസ് ലമോ നോ യു ആർ മിസ്റ്റേക്കൺ ഓണർ നജാലിയ സ്റ്റെപ്പനോവ ദർ മൈൻ ദെൻ നജാലിയ ജസ്റ്റ് തിങ്ക് ഇഫ് one, my slave is how long have they been yours? How it is? How long? As long as I can remember. Understood? എന്നു മുതല നിങ്ങളുടെ എനിക്ക് ഓർമ്മ വന്ന നാൾ മുതലേ അത് എൻ്റെതാണ്. നെതാലിയ, റിയലി യു വോണ്ട് ഗെറ്റ് മീ ടു ബിലീവ് ദാറ്റ്? അല്ലാമോ, ബട്ട് യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഫ്രം ഡോക്യുമെന്റ്സ്. ഹോണർ നെതാലിയ സ്റ്റെപ്നോവ്ന. Then here, Oaks and Meadows, it's true, were once the subject of dispute. But now everybody knows that once, in one time, that means one long years ago, it's a subject of dispute. Adoru endanoru dispute inde subject aayirunnu. But it's now, we all know that there are nothing to argue about. You see, my aunt's grandmother gave the free use of these meadows in perpetuity to the peasants of your father's grandfather. ഓക്കേ, മൈ ഹൂ ഗേവ് മീ ഓണ്ടിൻ്റെ ഗ്രാൻഡ് മദർ നിന്റെ ഫാദറിൻ്റെ ഗ്രാൻഡ് ഫാദറിന് എന്ത് ചെയ്യാൻ കൊടുത്തതാണ്? ഫ്രീ യൂസ്. ഓക്കേ, ദൻ ഇൻ റിട്ടേൺ ഫോർ വിച്ച് ദേ വാണ്ട് ടു മേക്ക് ബ്രിക്സ് ഫോർ ഹർ ആൻഡ് ഫോർ ഹർ. അതിന് തിരിച്ച് നിങ്ങൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യണം? തിരിച്ച് നിങ്ങൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യണം? ആ ഷുവർലി യു വാണ്ട് ടു ഫ്രീ യൂസ് തന്നപ്പോൾ അതിന് തിരിച്ച് മേക്ക് ബ്രിക്സ് ഫോർ ഹർ, ബ്രിക്സ് തിരിച്ചു കൊടുക്കണം. ബ്രിക്സ് മേക്ക് ബ്രിക്സ് ഫോർ ഹർ. ആൻഡ് ദ പെസൻസ് ബിലോങ്ങിങ് ടു യുവർ ഫാദേഴ്സ് ഗ്രാൻഡ് ഫാദർ ഹാഡ് ദ ഫ്രീ യൂസ് ഓഫ് മെഡോസ് ഫോർ 40 ഇയേഴ്സ്. ഓക്കേ, ആൻഡ് ഹാഡ് ടു ഗോട്ട് ഹി ഹാഡ് ഗോട്ട് ഇൻ ടു ദ ഹാബിറ്റ് ഓഫ് റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദം ആസ് ദർ ഓൺ വെൻ ഇറ്റ് ഹാപ്പൻ ഇറ്റ്. ഓക്കേ, ലിസൺ അഗെയിൻ ലമോഫ്. ബട്ട് യു കെൻ സീ ഫ്രം മൈ ഡോക്യുമെന്റ്സ്. You can see from the documents. Honor, Natalia, Stepnonna. Oaks and Meadows, it's true, were once is a subject of dispute. I agreed. But now everybody knows that they are mine. There is nothing to argue about it. You see, my aunt's grandmother gave the free use of these meadows in perpetuity. Perpetuity means the continuity. Continuity to peasants of your father's grandfather. Okay. In return for which they were to make bricks for her. The peasants belonging to your father's grandfather had the free use of meadows for 40 years and had got into the habit of regarding them as their own. When it happened that? Natalia, no, it isn't all like that. Both grandfather and great grandfather reckoned that their land extend to Blunt Marsh. Then here they considered, then all of you listen, reckon means considered. No, it isn't all like that. Both grandfather and great grandfather reckoned, considered that their land extend to Blunt Marsh. Which means Oaks and Meadows were ours. എന്താണ് ഇവിടെ മുതൽ ബേർച്ച്വുഡ് മുതൽ എന്താണ് പിന്നെ സ്ഥലം എന്താ ബ്ലണ്ട് മാർഷിന്റെ വരെ എന്താണ് അത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ. ഓക്കേ, അതിന്റെ ആ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ്റെ അടിയിൽ നടുവിലുള്ള സംഭവമാണ് ആര് ഓക്സ് ആൻഡ് മെഡോസ്. വിച്ച് മീൻസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓക്സ് ആൻഡ് മെഡോസ് ആർ വേർഡ് അവേഴ്സ്. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് സീ ദാറ്റ് ദർ ഈസ് ടു ആർഗ്യു അബൌട്ട് ഇറ്റ്. സിംപ്ലി സിലി. ഓക്കേ, ക്യാൻ യു ഫോളോ മീ? ഓക്കേ, ഇതെല്ലാം ഐ വിൽ ഷോ യു ദ ഡോക്യുമെന്റ്സ്. Natalia Stepnonna. Then Natalia, no, you are simply joking or making fun of me. What a surprise. We have had the land for nearly 300 years and then we are suddenly told that it isn't ours. Ivan Vasilevich, I can hardly believe my own ears. These meadows aren't worth much to me. They only come to far dissident. Dissientes. And are worth perhaps 300 rubles. But I can't stand unfairness. Say what you will, I can't stand unfairness. Okay, there are more. I will show you the document, Natalia Stepnovna. Then here, no more. You are simply joking or making fun of me. What a surprise. We have had the land for nearly 300 years. And then we are suddenly told that it isn't ours. Ivan Vasilevich, I can hardly believe, I couldn't believe my own ears. These meadows are in both much to me. You know that it's not much more, but it's not worth more. The only come to 5 decisions are the worth perhaps 300 rubles. Atre ullu. Ni adinu vendi oru kallatharam varenda avashyam illa. Okay. Can't stand unfairness. Orikkalum endan unfair aayittu I couldn't. Then here say what you will. I can't stand unfairness. Okay. Only 300 rubles cost. Okay. Atre 300 rubles ullu aa sthalathine. Adinu vendi endina ingane kallatharam varenda. Lamo. Hear me out. Hear me out. Please hear me. I implore you, that I am begging you. What is that? The presence of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor of explaining to you, used to bake bricks for my aunt's grandmother. Now my aunt's grandmother wishing to make them a present. Interrupter, by then here all of you listen. But I beg, hear me out, please, please hear. I implore you, I beg you, the presence of your father's grandfather, the peasants of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor of explaining to you, used to bake bricks for my aunt's grandmother. Now, my aunt's grandmother wishing to make them a present. Then he tried to complete something. Appa adu parayunnathinu munne interrupted by Natalia. Adu complete cheyyunnathinu munne thanne Natalia kethu parayana. I can't make heads or tail of all about the aunts and grandfathers and grandmothers. The meadows are ours. Njan head or tail onnu nokkunnilla. No need to hear anything. Oxen meadows are ours. Okay. Actually for what purpose our Lamo came the Godha? He forgot everything. They started to argue upon quarrel over a over oxen meadows. Lamo, mine. Natalia, ours. You can go on probing it for 2 days on end. You can go and put on 15 dress jackets. But I tell you, there are ours. നിനക്ക് പോയിട്ട് എന്തായാലും 15 ജാക്കറ്റ് ഒക്കെ ഇട്ടിട്ട് ഇനിയും വരാം. പക്ഷെ എന്താണ് ഞാൻ എന്നോട് പറയുന്നു, ഓക്സൻ മെഡോസ് ആർ അവേഴ്സ്. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് എനിത്തിങ് ഫോർ യുവേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് ടു ഗീവ് യു ഓഫ് മൈൻ ആൻഡ് സോ ദർ ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് യുവേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഐ ഡിഡൻ ഗീവ് എനിത്തിങ് ഓഫ് മൈൻ. ഓക്കെ. ദെൻ ലമോ, നിഥാലിയ സെഡ് നോ നാ, ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് ദ മെഡോസ് ബട്ട് ഐ ആം ആക്ടിങ് ഓൺ പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഐ ആം ഫെയർ. ഇഫ് യു ലൈക്ക് I will make you a present of them. Surely, നിനക്ക് വേണമെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഞാൻ നിനക്ക് തരാം. അതിന് വേണ്ടി ഒരു ആർഗ്യുമെന്റ് വേണ്ട. പക്ഷെ അത് എൻ്റെത് തന്നെ ആണ്. നിന്നെ ദാനിയ, ഐ ക്യാൻ മേക്ക് എ പ്രസന്റ് ഓഫ് ദ മൈ സെൽഫ് ബിക്കോസ് ദർ മൈൻ. എൻ്റെതിന് എനിക്ക് തന്നെ പ്രസന്റ് ആയിട്ട് എന്തിനാ? നോ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് മൈൻ. യു ആർ യുവർ ബിഹേവിയർ ഈ വൈൻ വാസ് ലൈക്ക് ഇറ്റ്സ് സ്ട്രേഞ്ച് ടു സേ ദ ലീസ്റ്റ് അപ് ടു ദിസ് വി ഹാവ് ഓൾവേസ് തോട്ട് ഓഫ് യു ആസ് എ ഗുഡ് നൈബർ. A friend, last year we lent our threshing machine. We lent you our threshing machine. Although on that account we had to put off our own threshing till November. But you behaved to us as if we were gypsies, giving me my own land. Indeed, no, really that is not at all neighborly. In my opinion, it's even impudent. If you want to know, then try to let we the people, we the people like that. We have any quarrel, namale angeye pandugal pandumbundeye nadana karyakal ingane kutipokki kondaranu le enna nukku thannilla edittu nee enno ingane le bihe anna ormundu nanakile nana angane irunappo namale ingane parayum അന്ന് അങ്ങനെ അത്രയും വലിയ സമ്പാട് അന്നെ ആരെ ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്തത്? ഞാനല്ലേ, റൈറ്റ്. അന്ന് ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ ആ ഇത് മാറ്റി വെച്ചിട്ട് ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ കൂടെ വന്നില്ലേ, റൈറ്റ്. പറയില്ലേ അതേപോലെ തന്നെ ആ ഒരു സെൻസിൽ അതിങ്ങനെ ഇമാജിൻ ചെയ്ത് പോന്നാൽ ഈ പ്ലേ എന്താണ്? സിമ്പിളാണ്. ഓക്കെ. ദെൻ ഐ ക്യാൻ മേക്ക് യു എ പ്രസന്റ് ഓഫ് ദ മൈ സെൽഫ് ബിക്കോസ് ദേ ആർ മൈൻ. യുവർ ബിഹേവിയർ ഇവൻ മെസ്ലേവിച്ച് ഇസ് സ്ട്രേഞ്ച് ടു സേ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് അപ് ടു ദിസ് വി ഹാവ് ഓൾവേസ് തോട്ട് ഓഫ് യു ആസ് എ ഗുഡ് നൈബർ. A friend, last year nanku ormalle we lent, we offered you our threshing machine. Nanku njangal avare threshing machine thannu. And although on the account we had to put off our own threshing till November. Njangal till November vare put off, we just postponed our thing. Then here, but you behave to us as if we were gypsies people. പക്ഷെ നീ ഇപ്പൊ ബിഹേവ് ചെയ്ത് ഞങ്ങള് ഒരു ജിപ്സികളോട് എന്ന പോലെയാണ് ഞങ്ങളോട് ബിഹേവ്. വി വേർ ജിപ്സീസ്. and giving me my own land. Indeed, no, really, that is not at that all thy body. In my opinion, it's even impure, and that means not respect. And if you want to know, okay, you ഒരു ബഹുമാനമില്ലാത്ത ആൾക്കാരെ പോലെ ബിഹേവ് ചെയ്യണ്ടേ. ദെൻ ലോമോ, ദെൻ യു മേക്ക് ഔട്ട് ദാറ്റ് ഐ ആം എ ലാൻഡ് ഗ്രാബർ. അനാദർ വിഷയം, അനാദർ അനാദർ മാറ്റർ. നീ എന്താ പറഞ്ഞാലും ഒരു ലാൻഡ് ഗ്രാബറാണ്. ദെൻ മാഡം, നെവർ ഇൻ മൈ ലൈഫ് ഐ ഹാവ് ഗ്രാബ്ഡ് എനിബഡി എനിബഡി എൽസ് ലാൻഡ്. ഐ ഷാൻ്റ് അലോ എനിബഡി ടു അക്യൂസ് മീ ഓഫ് ഹാവിംഗ് ഡൺ സോ. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഇമാജിനേഷൻ ഇല്ല. ഇമാജിൻ ചെയ്ത് നോക്ക് എന്താ അന്നേരം പറയാം, ഞാനൊരു ലാൻഡ് ഗ്രാബർ ആണെന്നോ? ഷുവർലി മാഡം, നെവർ ഇൻ മൈ ലൈഫ് ഹാവ് ഐ ഗ്രാബ്ഡ് എനിബഡി എൽസ് ലാൻഡ്. ഐ ഷാൻ്റ് അലോ എനിബഡി ടു അക്യൂസ് മീ ഓഫ് ഹാവിംഗ് സോ. ചിക്കുളി സ്റ്റെപ്സ് ടു ദ കരഫ് ആൻഡ് ഡ്രിങ്ക്സ് മോർ വാട്ടർ. ഓക്സൻ മെഡോസ് ആർ മൈൻ. ഓക്കെ, ദെൻ നരാലിയ, ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ട്രൂ, ദേ ആർ അവേഴ്സ്. ലമോ, മൈൻ. ഓക്കെ, ദെൻ ഇഫ് യു if you reach its then adu correct aya endileke nammude correct aayittu adu nammale ee playde theme manasilakki kanna, it's very easy. Understood? Okay, then read next dialogue. Okay, then Natalia, it's not true, I will prove it. I will send my mores out to the meadows this very day. A person who cuts grass with a mower, adana surely njan ippo thanne oru mowers ne send cheyyum cut cheyan, endana cut out to the meadows this very day. Lamo, what? Natalia, my mowers will be there this very day. Lamo, I will give it to them. ഞാൻ അവളെ പിടിച്ച് ഞാൻ കഴുത്ത് പിടിച്ച് പുറത്താക്കും എന്ന് പറയും. പ്ലീസ് ഡോണ്ട് ഷൗട്ട്, യു കാൻ്റ് ഷൗട്ട് യുവർ സെൽഫ് ഹൗസ് ഇൻ യുവർ ഓൺ ഹൗസ്, ബട്ട് ഹിയർ ഇറ്റ് മസ്റ്റ് ആസ്ക് യു ടു റിസ്ട്രെയിൻ യുവർ സെൽഫ്. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? കീപ് അണ്ടർ കൺട്രോൾ. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? നിനക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ ചെമ്പിളിക്ക് നിന്റെ വീട്ടിലിടാ, അവിടെ കിടന്നിട്ടോ ചെമ്പിളിയൊന്നും തന്നിട്ടില്ല. നല്ലമോ, ഇഫ് ഇറ്റ് വാസന്റ് എ മാറ്റർ ഫോർ ദീസ് ഓഫ് ദൻ എക്സ്ക്രൂഷിയേറ്റിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് സിവിയർ പാൽപിറ്റേഷൻ, ഓർ ഇഫ് മൈ ഹോൾ ഇൻസൈഡ് വാസ് അപ്സെറ്റ്, ഐ വുഡ് ടോക്ക് ടു യു ഇൻ എ ഡിഫറെന്റ് വേ. യെസ്, ഓക്സൺ മെഡോസ് ആർ മൈൻ. ഹി ബിക്കം, അപ്പൊ ഹാർട്ട് ബീറ്റ് കൂടാൻ തുടങ്ങി. ഹി ബിക്കം നെർവസ്. നറ്റാലിയ ours. Lamo, mine. Natalia, ours. Lamo, mine. Okay, then who enters? Chupko, what's the matter? What are you shouting for? Natalia, papa, then please tell this gentleman who wants ox and meadows we all keep. That's all. Then Chupko to Lamo, darling, the meadows are ours. Understood? Okay, then all of you want to read your chapter well. And if you face any difficulties, just contact me. Okay, inshallah we can took chapter in our next class. I think we can complete that chapter that day itself. Okay, my dears, read well. Okay, thank you.